देन वी कैन स्टार्ट।
17 people are there, including me.
Okay, so I guess let's start.
Okay, so let's start. Hi folks, very good afternoon. This is Jasneet. So for the today's session, our topic is gate. Without any delay, let's start by checking out our agenda. So we will be covering version controlling system, distributed versus centralized systems, Git and its installation, repository and their respective operations, staging areas, commits, push pull and clone. So what is version controlling system? So version controlling system is an application software which creates a group of files which has the access to monitor the files that we that are resided in the repository. So version controlling system allow us and give the ability to revert the file to previous states, and we can revert entire projects to its previous states. Okay, so we can also compare changes over time, like what we have changed so far and at what time we made the changes and who made the changes, like with respect to time span. And it can be distributed or centralized.
Jasneet, have you shared your screen? Is it visible to everyone? I don't see anything.
Yes,
it is visible.
Yes, we can see it.
I can also see.
I guess you need to pin the presentation.
It's already pinned. Okay, you go ahead. I'll join back.
So let's continue to distributed system and centralized systems. So both are the types of version controlling system and provide different architecture to work with. Like centralized system works on the client server architecture and require network to access. It contains a single copy at server on which all the developers used to work on. And if central system gets failed, the all of our work gets destroyed. Okay, so we have a new system which is distributed system. So in this system, we have a dedicated copy of code base on local machine. Any developer can change whatever they need to, and they can later merge their code on GitHub. GitHub is basically a cloud service provided by GitHub, and which embeds the Git distributed system in it. Also, we can easily collaborate on GitHub. Like, it provides the member accessibility, like who can access what and like so. So for the example of distributed system, we have Git, Bitkeeper, Fossil, etc. in market. So the most widely used software is Git. So we will be looking into that only. So Git and installation. Git is basically a distributed version controlling system developed by Linus Torvalds. And Linus Torvalds is the father of Linux operating system. Git is basically designed to manage the Linux kernel, which is a very large software on which controls the operating system itself. So Git has the ability to easily manage our software and products. So Git is also open source, so anyone can change as per their need. And it's widely being used by different organization, whether it is small or big. So to install Git, we need to go to Git SCM site, and it will give a direct download link. from where we can download the application software. So let me go to that site. So here we have our download for Windows, and as per your operating system, it will show. So to install Git, it's similar like clicking next only. Any confusion so far?
No.
Okay, so shall we continue?
Yes.
Okay. So Git is basically revolves around repository. A repository is basically a software, a folder, can say a central location in which data is stored or managed. It can also involve version control system to control the versions of our product. So Git involves various operations like initializing a repository, adding the changes into staging area, committing the changes, checking out the logs, staging and unstaging if we don't want to check commit anything. And we can even push our changes to a remote directory. We can revert the changes that we have done and committed so far. And we can commit revert the local changes that we don't want to commit as well. Okay, so before moving to the practical, let's take a look at Git staging part itself. So Git follows a three-tree architecture, which basically consists of three stages, like modified, staging, and committed. So whatever we changes, we put some changes in the repository, those changes come in the modified state, like a local working directory. And whenever we want to track those changes, we used to add those changes in a staging area by using a simple command git add. And if we want to commit those changes, like if our feature is stable and we can go with it, we will use the git commit command to commit those changes so that we can check in later. So let's move to the practical usage of this commands. Let me move to my empty folder. Okay, so I'm creating a base, a simple folder with name project1. And in this, I have after installing Git, we will get two utilities. One is GUI and one is Bash. You can go whatever you think handy. I use with command line, so I'm going with Bash. So Bash is built on Ming GW64. It's a Linux-based command line, so we can run any Linux-based commands like this. Let's say if I want to create a file, I can simply hit touch test.txt. It will create a file in this folder. It's an empty file. Let me remove this. So let's initialize our repository by using a simple git command using git init. So it will create a .git folder which is hidden and contains some version controlling files, which has the access of monitoring files, which we will be creating later in this repository. So let's take a look at the status, what our repository sees. So to see that, we used to hit git status. So it says we are on master branch, we have no commits so far, and we have nothing to commit. So let's create a simple file by using touch command. Let's say index.html. So now let's see the status again. So it shows like we have an untracked file. That means we have a modified file, but we didn't track it yet. So it shows under untracked file. To track this file, we need to add this into our staging area. To do so, we need to put a command like git add file name like index.html. So it's tracked now by our version controlling system, that is Git. So now again we are seeing status and it's showing like we are on master branch. We have not committed yet and we have a new file which is waiting for commit. And let's commit this empty file by using command git commit hyphen m for message and message in single quotes like initial. It should be meaningful. Like if we are looking backward in future, we will be easy. We will easily find what we have changes, what we have done. Like so, I have created a simple file index.html. So I'm writing. So let's see status again. So we have nothing to commit. And we can check the log by going with git log. So it will show the whole history, what we have done, like author, date, and what we have committed in depth. So we can see this by another command in summarized way by using one line as a flag. So it will show in a single line. It will be handy in large commits. Any confusion so far? Or doubts?
So are we still on the local or are we committing?
Yeah, we are working on local directory.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Anything else? Okay, let's move further. Now let's make some changes in our index file. So I have opened my repository in VS Code and now I'm adding a simple markup into it. But so I have added some content to my file that we have committed before. Now let's check out the status again. So I'm hitting git status. Now it's saying like we have a modified file and the name of the file. So we can commit, we can, now the changes are in modified state. Like I have said earlier, we have three states, working directory, staging area, and repository. So we have these changes in modified state. So if we want to move these changes into the staging area, we need to add these changes into the staging area by using git command, using git add, and the file name again. So it will move those changes into the staging area. Now let's hit git status. So to distinguish between staging area and modified area, let's create another file again without committing this file. So I'm creating a CSS file here. Okay, now let's check the status again. So now git showing both stages, like we have some changes in staging area and some we have modified state. So if we want, so if we commit something, it will look into the staging area only, not in the untracked stage. So now let's commit the changes. Git commit. Now it will only commit the index file, not the style file. To check this, let's see the status again. So we have style.css in the modify state. That's not committed here. So to commit the changes, we need to add it into staging area for sure. Without adding it into staging area, we cannot commit. Any doubt?
No.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay, so let's move to our next command.
Hey, Jasmine.
Yeah.
Can you show that how that like let's say if there are some difference like between the committed changes and stage changes or changes in the working directory? So yeah. If you have that, so if you can show that differences in VS Code, like it shows line by line differences.
Yeah. So we have an extension in VS Code, or we can do without extension. So let's go without extension first. So Git provides a utility to check the changes by using git k command. So if we use git k, it will provide a user interface where we can check who committed and when and what changes they have made. So we have a master branch and we committed first with a simple file without any content. So it's showing like a blank file here. We don't have any content. So after that, we added some content in the index file. So it's showing the changes we have made. Yeah. So we have this utility and another one is, I guess this one. So yeah, so we have a file history section here in the git length extension. So it shows in the VS Code itself like this. If we click on any commit, it will show the data what we have changed. Like I created a file with no content, so it's showing no content in this. And next commit was to add the changes, so it's showing like I have nothing before, and after changes I committed, I got this markup in it. And it shows the changes based on lines, not the characters or words. Let's say if I change something in the line itself. Testing commit. Now I check status, it will again show me the modified state, like I have added some changes. So I'm committing that again, git add index.html. Now I'm committing, git commit. So now see, we have inserted a line and we deleted another line. Why it's showing like this? I just added some content, not deleted anything. So the reason behind this is Git cannot monitor the exact characters or words what we have changed. It checks based on lines. So let's check the history again. See, so it's showing like I removed this line and added this line, not some words or characters. Any doubt?
Is there any way like and just now we are adding one file only, like in real-time project we need to add more than 10 files, right? So
yes.
Is there any way like we need to add 10 files at a time, like without
we have a flag for
adding
that.
Any code?
like by, yeah, we have a flag for that. Like my style file is unstaged now. Let me make some copies for this. And I have around 5 copies of this file. Let's check for the status now. So we have 5 untagged files. So to add these all in a single command, we used to add a flag by using get add hyphen e. Sorry. I used to do by using dot, like it shows all. Now, if we check for git status, it will move the all changes into the staging area in one.
Okay, do you have any like for particular file? I don't I wanted to add some particular file but don't wanted to add all the files.
Yeah, so to add a particular file, we need to add the path for that, like by adding git add, and we need to specify the path of the file, like style.css. In that case, it will add only the file that we have mentioned, like before we added for index.html. Let's unstage this and again try. To unstage, we have a simple command using git restore hyphen hyphen staged and dot. So it unstaged all the changes we have done. So now let's stage any particular file by using its path. So let's add git add and style.css. Now I'm adding only style.css. It will not add these files, the copy of the file. So let's see status again. So we have the style.css in the stage area and we don't have any other file in the staging area. I guess this is the answer to your question.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. So now let's revert the changes. Okay, so let's create some changes, then we will try to revert those changes. Okay, I'm adding some changes in style file. So I'm adding my changes again to the staging area. Okay, add. We can use dot if we want to add all or one. Okay, status now. We have a file style.css again in staging area. Now I am committing those. Git commit hyphen m edit style. So we have nothing to commit now. Now let's check on the logs we have done. Okay, log hyphen one line. So we have 4 commits. Like one, we have created index file, we have added markup, we have added some changes to the body and added a style class. So now if we want to revert the last change, we have 3 ways to do that. Like we can revert those changes by creating another commit, we can reset the changes by using hard command, so it will remove the commit with but it will remain the changes what we have done, and there's one command I guess with that is deprecated, which will not retain the changes as well. So let's try both one by one. So now I added the, now I'm reverting my changes of added the changes in body. So to do so, I will be using git revert and the ID of commit. So by using this, it So we got some commit, like Git is not able to resolve the commit. Like we have added the changes in a single line. So it will be showing some heads in our file like this. So to so it asking us to retain the changes, what we need and what we don't need, we can remove. So we are removing the testing commit from here and removing this heads. Okay, now we can commit, like git commit. Okay. Okay, so we need to add these changes in staging area again by adding git add dot. Now we can commit. So to commit, git commit. So it will give a Vim interface where we can change the commit message, or we can go with the same that it is providing. So to do the commit, we need to hit escape, and now we need to hit colon and write to. We need to hit W for writing, and then we need to quiet, so we will be adding Q, and after that it will write our changes. So it status we will check. Now we have these changes in the repository. So now let's look into the status logs again. Okay, log hyphen hyphen one line. So it created another commit and didn't remove the existing. So it's safer to do, like if we want to revert any changes. And if we really want to delete the commit, we can use reset. So to do so, we will be using git reset, and we need to use hyphen hyphen hard flag to do so. And if we want to reset to a particular commit, we will be using commit id. Otherwise, if we want to reset the last commit, we will be using head and tilt and the number of commits we want to remove, like one. So after that, it will remove our last commit that we have done by resolving the commit, resolving the merges. Now we will be checking status again. So we don't have any changes, and we can look into our file, like we have testing commit again, and let's check the logs again. So we don't have that revert added markup to index now. Right. Any doubt?
No, you can
go ahead. Okay.
Yeah, we are good.
Okay. So now, like, it's not feasible to work on a single branch. Like, by default, Git provides a single branch, which is master. And we can check it by using command git branch hyphen a. So it will show all the branches we have in the repository. So branches is nothing but a separate isolated path in which we can develop our own feature. Let's say if our this website is stable and we want to add some JavaScript into it, and we don't want to change in our existing code base before confirming that our changes are okay or our feature are good to go. So we can move to a separate branch, and we can changes in that branch, like by creating a separate branch. So to create a separate branch, we can use git checkout hyphen b for creating a new branch and branch name, like feature one. So we have a separate branch with this code base of master. Now let's check on the status. We have clean window. Now let's change something in this branch. let's say we are adding some script and added alert in it. So I have added a simple alert by creating another function and added a log as well. Simple message. Like if we have disabled the alert, we can see the message in console as well. So I have added a simple alert function. So let's commit this on our new feature branch. Like by using git status, we can see the changes, and we can add the changes into staging area by using git add dot. And now let's commit the changes. Now we have no changes in our modified area. Okay, so now let's check on the branches and its content. Like I have done the changes in my feature one branch. Now let's check out our master branch again. Master. Yeah, so it does not have those changes yet. Like we need to merge those changes after we are successfully done with our feature. Now let's say we are done with our feature branch and we need to merge our changes in our actual production site. So we will be doing this by using git merge, and the branch name we need to merge in our master branch. To do so, let's say I want to add the changes from feature one branch. So I'm mentioning feature one branch in here and hitting enter. So my changes are added in master itself. Now let's look into the log again. Git log one line. So it will also show the commits history, what we have done in different branch. So it's handy if multiple developers are working on a single code base and they can have separate feature branches and they can later merge by using a central repository on GitHub. Any doubt?
So here the merge is between the feature one and the master branch.
Yeah.
If we have the feature two branch and I want to merge the feature one with feature two, not with the master, how will you go for that?
Yeah, so to do so, we will be checking out to the branch in which we need to merge, and then we will hit the command like git merge, and the branch we need to merge in our current branch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so can you show that? Can you create one more branch and merge the changes to that one?
Yeah, we can do that. Like to create a new branch, we can check out to a new branch by using git checkout -b for new branch and feature two. So now I'm adding some changes in feature two branch. Yes. Now let's check for the status. Now we have some modified file. Now I'm committing those. Okay. Also, we can do both adding and committing in a single command by using git commit -am or by using git commit -a -am separately. And edit. New feature two. So we are currently in feature two branch. Now let's check out to feature one. Check out feature one. So we don't have the feature to code base yet here. To merge those changes, we can do like so, git merge feature 2. And we have the changes of feature 2 in feature 1. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's check our next topic. Okay. So now we have talked about the Git for now. It's a application software. Now we have another thing that is GitHub. And GitHub is nothing but a hosting for our projects. So we can host on the cloud and different collaborators can access and do changes. So Git is a hosting provider, and on the top of it, we have Git installed on it. So we can do Git operation on GitHub as well. And it's a social network for our projects. So to now we can do pull and push operation with Git repository on our remote location, that is GitHub. So let's take an example for that. Now let's create a new repository on GitHub. Let's say project. Okay. I'm choosing public, so collaborator can fork my repository and introduce changes. So we can provide description for our new project if we want to, like, and we can initialize a readme file as well. Now I'm creating without this and creating a repository. So now I have a repository at my GitHub account. To clone it local and to work on it, I just need to use a simple command, which is git to clone. Let's do it in our now. So now to access the git repository, we need to provide credentials to access my account. So to avoid those, we have two ways. Like either we can use the Windows credential manager. I'm not using that. Like I used to do by using SSH. Like Linux provide the way to interact between two Linux environment by using SSH keys, which is specifically a RSA key, and it's a pair of public and private key. Like so, and it's most widely used. So we will be using that only. So to generate those, we will be using a simple command. It's SSH-T RSA and the mail ID of my registered account. So let's create a SSH key. Now we will go to the bash and create a new brand new SSH key by using the SSH-T. I need RSA key and for my account. I missed something. Okay, I need to add -c as well. So it will ask for some, where to save, like we will be checking out to default directory, that is SSH directory in my document folder right here. So while communicating with my report repository, window will look, git will look into my .ssh folder for the keys. So let's choose the default by and it asks for the passphrase. Let's skip those. Same passphrase again. Now we have two keys. One is private and one is public. So we will be adding this public key in our GitHub account so that we can whitelist our private key for the communication purpose. To do so, we will go into our settings. Now from here, we have a SSH and GPG keys, and we will add SSH key here. And we will add those key right here. So now our public key is whitelisted here. Now we can communicate with our, now my machine can communicate with the remote directory without using credentials of my account. So now let's clone our brand new repository that we have created on GitHub. To do so, let's move to the Git session. Now let's open bash here and we will be doing git clone. We need the SSH link for the repository that we have created. So this is the SSH link for my repository. I will be cloning right here and I will hit it.
Yeah, so as I was saying, whatever the changes that we do over here, these are all done locally, yes. Right? On the local. And what if I want to, like, let's just say you and I are working on the same sandbox.
Yes.
Right? And now I want to test my changes. And you are also working on the same class, and I'm also working on the same class. Then do you think this version controlling will be still maintained? Because every now and then, you and I will have to test our changes, right? So yes. If override the changes, then in that case, how do we manage that?
So in that case, we need to introduce another sandbox so that each developer can work independently. Like both of them are working on a same file and testing, like they are checking their output on, for same file. It's not possible to like check on the server, but we can maintain version locally. Like we have a separate copy for that. If like we have two developers, developer one and developer two, and they both are working on index.html file. So locally they have their own version that they can deploy before testing their changes. But on sandbox or let's say on server, we cannot maintain those changes.
Okay, so this particular whole thing can be only, I mean, it is useful when each developer have their own sandbox and they are when they are doing the changes, and this is for the version control for the deployment, right? Because you might have deployed changes from sandbox to production, and then I will deploy my changes. So before deploying, when we have to merge the code, then this GitHub plays the main role, right?
Yes. Okay. And we can do merging regularly, like to avoid merge conflicts. So a release admin can easily solve those merge. Like if we are merging it after, let's say our project gets complete and then we are trying to merge, then we will get lots of merge conflicts, and we need to check that what we need to retain and what we need to delete, kind of.
Right. So now let's just say I already have one repository, and then I have done some changes, and let's just say I have created two new classes, and then regularly in a week or twice in a week I'll have to merge the changes, right, in the repository.
You can do regularly, like on the day basis.
Okay. And how do we do this pull and push request then?
Yeah, it's simple. Like, just need to hit git pull to pull the changes, and to push the changes into the remote, we will be using git push. And okay, so if we want to push to a particular branch, we will be mentioning the branch name after that command, like git push and branch name.
Okay, so we can do that. We can push our changes to a particular branch as well.
Yeah. Okay. And as per your scenario, like if we have a single sandbox, like to see the changes, like let's say if developer one done some changes and he want to check whether he has done the right changes, so he will be deploying his all changes to the git first, and then he will be checking those changes. Okay, now after let's say if dev2 again want to see his changes, then he will be deploying his changes, and then he can see those changes. In that meantime, dev1 changes will get overwritten. Like in sandbox, we can have a single version.
Right, that is what my main question was.
Yeah.
So either a developer should have one
a separate copy.
Yeah, or they'll have to override their changes. Okay.
Yeah. Also, we can integrate it with ARM tools to do the automation of deployment as well. Like we have a local repository with all the changes, we can do by using ARM tool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Please check your mail.
Okay, checking. Yes. Edit. Now you can try cloning. Tushar, are you there?
Jasnit, can you do it from your system? Because
now yeah, actually, my keys are getting conflict with Wiley. So.
Okay.
Okay. I go desktop.
Yeah. Now, okay. You can create a folder in here.
Okay.
And we need to
close.
We need to do some configuration as well. Open bash. So we need to provide the information to Git, like who is changing and who is doing, who is the author and who is changing the changes. Like, so to do so, we will be using a configuration, global configuration file of Git. So you can write git config. You need space. -- global and space -- list. Yeah, it will list down the values of our configuration that is configured now.
Okay, so can I do enter?
Yeah. So you can see like name is now Neha Hale and email is neha.hale@akilaservices.com. So you can change it to mine so that Git will be knowing who is changing.
Okay.
So to do that, you will be doing something like git config. space hyphen hyphen global space user dot name space and my name in the double quotes here. Enter.
Okay.
Yeah, we need to change email as well.
Okay.
So you can click. Yeah.
Yes.
Email. Just remove this piece.
Just need to 96
at the rate gmail.com.
Okay. Gmail.com.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Now you can access my repository locally.
Okay.
I'm sharing you a link from where you can go. Tushar, your Slack is working?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, use this SSH link. Now type git clone.
Okay. Clone
and paste it by right clicking. Don't use Control V. Yeah, hit enter.
Okay, right.
Yeah, so it's come now. Yeah, just hit enter. I guess we are not able to communicate with GitHub.
Okay.
Just delete that repository and try again with same command.
Okay.
Like everybody has got idea about that. So maybe like Tushar, if you have some problem, you can connect offline. And if anybody has some questions, like they can ask and we can discuss the next steps.
I have a couple of questions. Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's just say I have existing repository, okay? Then how can I connect that with my sandbox? Because there may be scenarios that I want to create some new classes, or I want to do some changes to the existing classes and then commit. Then do this adding files to the repository and committing the changes will. I mean through this I can achieve that, or is there any other way to do that?
Yeah, you can achieve, like there can be two scenarios. Your repository can be local, or you can have a repository on GitHub.
Right.
So what scenario you are talking about?
I have a repository on GitHub.
Okay, so you need to first clone that repository in local by using git clone.
Right.
And then you can authorize your account for your org of Salesforce, and then you can work on that. Like you can create a separate branch for your features, and if you think that's stable, you can merge into master branch, and you can again commit back to master.
Okay. So whatever the changes that I'll do, that will be because now that I have cloned my repository on the local machine. So whatever the changes that I have done, that will be in my locally.
Yeah,
only,
local.
Right?
Yeah, so to push those changes, you need to use a git push and branch name in which you want to push.
Okay, so that is the main thing that we are about to learn, right? The pull and push request.
Yes, like okay. We are not able to do that.
Okay.
Anything else?
No, I mean, I wanted to see about the push and pull request actually.
Okay, so can we do that in next session?
Yeah, we want to have a next session.
On the next session, we'll be just having a pull and push where Jasneet or someone has the repository connected locally and everything established. Just he'll try to push and show that as a one of the demo. So in the next session, we'll have like any more questions if they have, and probably a quiz. Let's see if that happens, and a further demo of this. And whatever, if Jasneet gives the assessment assignment, he can like we can have questions on that.
Okay.
Anything else for now? Like you guys, any other guys, any other people have questions, concerns? Kuch puchna hai? Is koi koi kon kon use karta hai Git abhi apne apne project ke liye?
I do. I mean, you know.
I am also do.
Yeah.
Also do.
I'm also do in last 3 years.
Okay. Hania, you want to say something?
Yeah, I was just saying like most of us are not much aware about the Git and the connection to the sandbox and testing the changes and deploying and merging the code, you know. So if we could have that whole from like we or everyone is working on Salesforce only, so from Salesforce to, you know, merging the code and pushing the request and deploying the changes, so that whole demo, if we can see, then that would be really helpful. That is what I wanted to say.
Achha. Haan, theek hai, toh, I guess Jasneet, tum kuch Wiley ka hi code like naya changes karke tum log push kar sakte ho na tumhare Wiley wale branch mein.
Yes, I can do that.
Wo push and pull dikha do bas ek chota. And then okay. For detail, you can do it. Tell us next step. How much time it will take to do that in now?
I can do that now. Like it will take around 10 minutes.
Okay, you are all guys available? It's okay. If you want to do it now or shall we do it next weekend?
Can we do it in next weekend?
Okay. Baki aur ko koi dikkat to nahi na?
No.
Sabka silence, I'm considering it, yes. So let's do it in next weekend. So Jasneet, let's do it next weekend where tumhara live project ka hi dikha do. Kahan pe like you something you made changes in the Salesforce and you want to push, right? And simultaneously Gaurav is doing something on that same class and how you're merging it. That's the whole overall live scenario they want to see.
Okay.
Okay. So let's do that. Apart from this, I guess was there any remaining points from your slide?
No, that's all. Like only the Git push and pull was left.
Okay, great. Then let's circle back next Saturday, jahan pe pull and push dikhate and counter all the questions whatever guys has.
Okay, and I can share the list of commands.
Yeah, that will be helpful.
Yeah, please.
Okay. If anyone don't have any questions, I guess we can disperse.
Yeah.
Just a small question. This is visual. Jasneet, what is Git client? Because I need to work on.
Okay, so actually Git client is nothing but a application software that we are using to create repository locally. And in other terms, we can say that like client, like we have a center repository at GitHub and we are cloning that as a separate copy, and we are working on that. So we will be a Git client for that, like in terms of client server.
Okay. And yeah, so if I'm using VS Code for any changes, so is there any way that I just save the changes and it will be directly merged with the branch?
No, that you need to do manually, or you can write a script for that.
Okay, so yeah, automation.
You can create a anytime you can create a automation by using node modules or by implementing a simple node script that will be running behind and that will be doing your work.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. So I guess thank you, Jasmine. It was nice session. So we'll meet in next session. And so like meanwhile, if you have some ideas about any sessions, like if someone want to have some topic covered, let us know so we can arrange that session. And that's it.
Right. Okay, so next weekend we'll be having a Git session itself. So apart from pull and push, is there anything else you guys want to know? So it's easy that Jasneet is ready before the session. Okay. Chalega. Let's gather next weekend for the second half. Thank you guys. Thank you for your time. Thanks, Jasneet.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.